to show you how to connect Google Glasses with Siri. So first of all, let's see what is Google Glasses. Google Glass is a type of wearable technology developed by Google, and for now it's available only in the USA and the UK. In Italy it's not available. And as you can see from the image, on the right hand side of the glass there is a touchpad, and this touchpad can be used to perform some actions on the glasses. For example, by tapping on the touchpad you can activate the screen, you can perform some action, you can swipe forward and back to navigate the timeline, then we will see what is the timeline. And you can swipe down on the touchpad to come back to the preview screen, like the back button on the Android device. And this is the user interface of the Google Glasses. This is a timeline composed by cards. We have an on-screen home card that shows you the time, the current time, and let you start other applications using the home menu. On the right-hand side of the home screen, you have the path section. And on the left-hand side, you have the present and future section. On the extreme left, we have the settings of the glasses. So, in the timeline, we can have three kinds of cards. The static card is a card that can display text, images, video content, and so on. Also HTML5 content. And can contain menu items. For example, you can reply, share the content, or perform actions. For example, approve or reject a task. The other kind of card, this is the developer pattern of the study card. So you have the home menu on the center. On the right hand side, in the path section, the study card are pushed via an application. For example, a web service that pushed the static card on the left side of the home screen. The last card is another kind of card. It's like an Android application that can access every hardware feature of the glasses, for example the GPS or the accelerometer, and can run in also in the ground, and resides on the left-hand side of the home screen. And the development pattern is this one. So you can start the live card using the home menu, or a static card using its menu items. Then the live card is inserted on the left-hand side of the home screen. And of course, this kind of card can have menu items to stop the application, for example. The last type of card is the immersion. That is like the live card, so it's a normal Android application, but completely hides the timeline. So if you want to come back to the timeline, you have to swipe down with the touchpad. And the development pattern is exactly the same as the live card. So now that we know what are the cards, let's see how to develop for Google Glasses. We have two ways. One is the glass development kit, also called JDK. With this kind of development, you can access the hardware features, you have offline functionality, and so on. And it's like the normal kind of development for Android device. So you build the application, you install the application on the Google Glasses, and then you can start the application using the home screen. The other kind of development is the Mirror API. Mirror API is a group of web services provided by Google, REST web services. And the development part is the one that you can see on the right here. Your service, in this case SAP, in our example, called the Google services, Google Mirror API, and Google synchronized with Google Glasses pushing content on the glasses, like a push notification. The difference is that these contents that are static cuts can contain also manual items to perform some actions. So, just a recap, with the JDK you can develop live cards and dimension cards that are like Google Android applications. With the Mirror API you can only develop static cards. And today we will focus on the Mirror API, because Android developers we already know, more or less. So, what can we do with the static cards? We know that we have some limitations, no? So let's see a video that can give you us an idea of what we can do. So one example, the first example is an approval workflow. So SAP is sending content to the Google Glasses with the task to approve. In this case, the manager receives a new notification, a static card with some information. For example, I might remember that you have to approve this sales order, and also can contain some graphical information like bar charts or tables with values and other kind of charts. Finally, the manager tap on the card on the touchpad and can choose the approve or reject action that will synchronize with SAP calling a function module on the backend side. The second example is a text advisor that is driving using Google Glass, of course, driving near the customer. So SAP is able to intercept to understand where is the Google Glass in a particular interval of time, and can understand that Marco is near to the customer. So send him a notification: "Hi Marco, you are near the customer, so you have a meeting. Remember that you have to do this thing, and if you want to not get to the customer, just tap on the glass and the map is open." These are only some examples, you know, but you can do a lot of things. So, now, I told you that you can develop for Google Glasses using Mirror API without writing any code, or at least a very small set of code. How to do that? So I have to do a small recap on OAuth 2 before to explain you. OAuth 2 is a service provided by Google that provides the client application a secure delegated access to server resource on behalf of a resource owner. In this case, SAP is connecting to Google on behalf of our Google Glasses user. And the client application, in this case Google, has to be registered with a valid Google account and with a valid client ID that identifies the application, the client. And what happens? So the client requests the token to the Google service. The user logs on and consent, the access. The Google server replies with a token, and this token can be used to perform any other request, for example, to call the Mirror API. This is the Mirror API functionality. For example, to manage the timeline, you have some methods, delete, insert a card, get the list of the cards, and so on. And the final result of all of this study is this, the Google API ABAP client. What is it? It's a library that is written in ABAP, and this library is the ABAP implementation of the standard Google libraries. For example, the Google API PHP client, Google API Java client, and so on. This library lets you use the Google APIs, any kind of APIs. For example, Google Maps, Google Drive, in this case, Google Glasses, Mirror API. And it's very simple to use. Now you just download the framework, import the objects using Sapling. You have to register the application with a Google client ID, as I told you before, for the Google Auth 2 authentication. And you have to install the certificates for Google, because the connections are over SSL, so are secure connected. And finally, you run the report and also work, no? The report do the following steps. Retrieve user data if the token is available for the user, the request is performed. In case the token expires, the token is refreshed and the request is performed with the parameters. Very simple, let's see directly on the system with data. So I am connected with Zoom. In Zoom we have our framework. This is the test program. These are the classes of the framework. As I told you, this is the Google client ID for the application, for the SDK application. This is our proxy. It's supported by the framework. And here, the user data are retrieved. And if the user has a valid token, what happens? A card is inserted on the user Google Glasses timeline. In this case, we are inserting an example of workflow approval reject task with a sales order. And then we are receiving the list of the items in the timeline of the user. So let's start our report. So as you can see, we already had one item in the timeline. Now we have two items. One is inserted now, approve reject example. So now if I switch on our simulator, this is the Google Glasses simulator, and this is a Google Glasses operating system modifier to run on Android, and as you can see now we got this static tab on the right hand side of the home screen, that is our approval and reject example with the sales order. If I tap on the card, I can approve or reject. And if I select one of these actions, you can see the refresh icon here on the left hand side. This means that it's calling SAP function module to perform the action. Okay, so now we finished the time, so I will show you something more in the next session. If you have any questions, I am happy to reply.
Thank you, Alessandro.
Oh, Alex.